tonight is renting the new reality. Even with mortgage rates at historic lows, more and more Americans are choosing to rent instead of buy. And it's not just homes. Car ownership rates for people under 30 have plummeted in recent years. And new and creative ways to rent everything from futons to baby clothes are cropping up everywhere. But does it really make economic sense not to buy? Here's ABC's Melody Hobson.
Wow, this is really cool.
Meet Brian Chesky, the 30-year-old chief executive of Airbnb, a real estate matchmaking site that pairs people seeking temporary rentals with those with room to spare.
In the wake of this economic environment, people are realizing that access is more powerful than ownership. It's more economically sustainable.
Airbnb started less than 5 years ago and is already estimated to be worth more than $1 billion.
Hello!
Robin Hoff rents out a room in this modest Victorian in Oakland, California for $59 a night. A luxury treehouse goes for $175 a night. And for the lucky few who can afford it, a 6,500 square foot ski house rents for $5,000 a night. And while the new American dream may include a white picket fence, it's not home ownership.
We used to be a bit more defined by the things we own, this idea of keeping up with the Joneses, and now it's this idea of like sharing with the Joneses.
It's been called the share economy, but it sounds more like rental nation.
Those tools in your garage, the treadmill in your bedroom, and that nice suit you only wear to anniversary parties?
It seems that everything is for rent these days. Household goods, parking spots, clothes, even baby toys. So how did we get here? Frightened by foreclosures, Americans are flocking in record numbers to rentals. In April, home ownership fell to its lowest level in 15 years. Even many who can afford to buy these days would rather rent.
So you've been renting this house for 2 years. Would you like to own it one day?
No. I think I save money renting instead of buying, especially obviously the real estate bubble that burst.
This is your bathroom.
And now Robin is renting out her rental. Airbnb guest Carson Basie is visiting from Albuquerque for the weekend.
And is this everything you were expecting?
Oh yeah, this is great.
Carson says it's better than a motel room. And Robin says she can make enough from Airbnb to cover her own monthly rent.
So does your landlord know that you are renting out a room?
They do now.
Across town, Sue Yeru rents her house with furniture.
Having less is more. For me, yeah, I have more freedom. I could pick up and leave tomorrow and have two suitcases. Well, maybe three. I've got a lot of shoes. But
and the Prius she drives to pick up her sister at the airport is rented, too.
How often are you using it?
I'd say about 3 times a week.
Does it feel like your car?
Absolutely. I love this car.
She has rented it through Relay Rides, which is kind of like Zipcar, but with a twist. And Zipcar gives renters access to a fleet in their own neighborhood. Now, Relay Ride says you can simply rent your neighbor's car.
I don't use the car every day, so it feels like a waste to have this resource.
In this case, the Prius belongs to Katerina Rindy, who lives just a block and a half up the street.
Financially, it doesn't really make sense to sell it either because I do use it enough.
Relay Ride's founder, Shelby Clark, says Katerina is the typical owner.
American car sits idle 92% of the time. And so it just doesn't make sense for a lot of people. You know, somebody else can be using that car, you can be helping out a neighbor and making cash.
30 years ago, you'd never would have imagined renting out your car. What do you think shifted for people that something that before was such a status symbol and so personal, now is something that they freely will rent out by the hour?
Social media is creating new ways to express yourself and interact with your friends. And so, as opposed to just being defined by the things that you own, you can express yourself in lots of other ways.
But for the customers, the bills can add up, bringing up the question of whether renting is always best. Sue has become such an active Relay Rides user that she says her rental bill is running about $200 a month. That's pretty close to what it would cost you if you owned a car, right?
But I'm not paying for gas.
Okay.
You know, all those added things.
Do you worry about the amount of renting that you're doing in terms of the wear and tear on the car?
No. I mean, I know it's a risk that there's going to be more wear and tear on the car, but the money that I'm making from the renting is paying for maintenance.
Everyone who signs up can get rated by their peers, with results showing up in an online profile. Katerina said she once had to blacklist a renter.
Everything was like greasy and I was like,
I don't know who this guy is, but I said, no, I don't want him renting the car again. He got like low stars and I was really irritated.
I could start renting immediately.
Whether Rental Nation is a fad or something that is here to stay may hinge on how renting problems are resolved.
I'm a car owner. I rent out my car. Someone has a terrible accident. You know, should I be worried?
We do not believe that car owners should have should be held liable for incidents that happen when a renter is driving their car.
The renters we met did not seem overly worried.
I mean, life is messy, and if something happened, we would clean it up.
I'm Melody Hobson for Nightline in San Francisco.